Hi guys, I'm Abhishek and I'm going to help you get 325 plus on the GRE in 45 days. So before we get into the video, let me tell you that I took the GRE a few months back and I scored a 330, which is 169 in quants, 161 in verbal and 5.0 AWA. You guys can see my score right here as I scored pretty decently on the GRE with just 45 days of preparation along with my internship, right? So if you're working, if you're studying in college, it's totally possible to get a great score along with your whatever you're doing, right? So without wasting any time, let's just get right into it. The first thing you will have to do is take a mock test, right? Before starting preparation, before doing anything, the first thing that you want to do is take a mock test. So a mock test is really important because you get to know kind of where you stand, right? You get to know where you need to improve on, where you're good, where you're bad, right? So how you can get a mock test is just, it's simple. Just go on Google and search for free GRE mock tests. And you'll get a lot of sources. I would suggest the first one you can go for is Kaplan. It is really accurate. It is very close to the actual GRE exam. So what you'll do is you'll click on sign up and then you can get a mock test. And once you do the mock test, you will get an analysis of your scores. You will get where you scored well, where you lost marks. You can see question by question analysis, which is a great way to start. So this is your day zero, right? Okay, so after your mock test, you're gonna know where you stand, right? So if you get anywhere around, this is important, please pay attention. If you get anywhere less than 300 in the GRE, I would suggest don't do this crash course, right? 45 days wouldn't be enough for you. You will need to put in more time, more effort, and you may watch this video if you like to, but it wouldn't help you that much because I would expect you to be at least at the 300 level in order to reach 320, 325, 330 by the 45 days, right? So subscribe to the channel. I will put on more content to go in details of each section and we can go into more depth, and over a period of time you can improve your score. But this particular crash course is for the people who get 300 plus on their first mock test, right? If you get 300 plus, I'm definitely sure that by the end of 45 days, you can get 320 plus, 325 plus, if you follow this step by step, the way I say it, right? Okay, so the next step would be to, once you've taken the mock test, you've got 300 plus, the next step would be to register for the exam. This is very important, right? You wouldn't get that seriousness if you don't register for it. So just think of it as your board exam, right? You know your board exam is on 1st March. So you will have to start preparing and you will take it seriously, right? That date is fixed. That date's not going to change. For that reason, I would like you to think about GRE as your board exam and book the date. And you can book it 45 days, 50 days from now. Just go to the GRE website and click on registration. Once you click on registration, just create your account. And after you create your account, you can see test centers and dates, and you can view the test centers. You can put a test, GRE general test, put your city, book your date, confirm that you're going to take the GRE, right? Once that is done, then your crash course starts. Okay. So once you book the GRE, the next thing is you need to prepare your sources, right? So there are many sources. Currently, Magoosh is a really good source, the one which I use and the one which I recommend the most. Then there's Manhattan Prep, Princeton Review, ton of sources, right? And all of them pretty much teach you the same thing because GRE remains the same. So the choice of your prep content doesn't matter, right? They're all good. They're all tried and tested and they're all trustworthy, right? But what you want to do is you want to take one and stick to it. You know, you don't want to keep dabbling between one or two different sources, right? Take one, stick to it. Okay, so once you decide which content you're going to go with, so it is all available online, right? You can get things for free as much as you can. You can get the ebooks. I personally didn't purchase any book. I used ebooks and online content to get the score, and I would suggest that is enough, right? Because even if you have a bundle of books and you don't read them, it's of no use buying them, right? Rather, I would suggest go to Magoosh's website, and there's this plan called the GRE prep plan, which is available in a 1 month and a 6 month variant. If you can buy this program, then definitely go ahead, recommend this program. And I think this program is really good It's an overall program. It improves your concepts, it improves your accuracy, it improves your timing, everything. All in one program. Definitely recommend it. Even if you can't get this, watch along. I will help you fill out this program as well. Okay, then the next thing is you need the GRE vocabulary flashcards app. You can again go for Barron's 800 and stuff, but I use this vocabulary flashcards app because I could have it on my mobile and I could, practice my words at any time, right? So this app, this is the iOS version of the app, and there's an Android version as well. Don't download any other app. This is the most beneficial app, I would say, and there are many duplicates on the markets. Download this exact application on your phone. What you're going to do is you're going to use the app, so it has around 1000 to 1100 words, and that's all you really need for your vocab, right? That's all I ever needed, and I scored as 161 on the GRE verbal. So I would say that this app, what you want to do is do 50 words per day, so that by the end of 20 days or 21 days you will have your words done. And then I would suggest, don't go to any other words, just revise these words, right? Retention is more important than the number of words you learn. Also, when you're doing these words, try to retain as many as possible. So how I would do it is, I would wake up in the morning. That's the best time to learn these words. Wake up in the morning, give my first 1 hour to just these words, right? Do 50 words, a set contains 50 words. Just do that set, master it. It takes 45 minutes to 1 hour, finish it off, right? Then later in the day or before you go to sleep, whenever you get 5 minutes of time, just revise those words. You can just, it randomly gives you the words and the meanings. Just revise those words and it will stay in your mind and you will retain it. And when you complete all the 1100 words, I would suggest do them again, because retention is going to help you the most on your exam day. So the next thing I would suggest is for the verbal, what remains is reading. So what you will do is, on the reading side, you just have to keep reading a lot of stuff on the internet and it's going to help you. You just want to get your reading speed up and the comprehension. What does it mean? Is you want to read and you got to understand as you're reading, right? So you don't need to read a line 4 times to understand it. You want to get to a point where you read the passage and on one go you understand it. It's not hard, just takes a bit of practice. So that's all you want to do about the vocabulary. Now coming to the math. For your first 20 days, the plan would be to learn these words and to do these questions without any timer, right? What I want you to focus on is accuracy. So there are two things, accuracy and timing. You have to nail both of them to get 169, 170 on the quants. So what you want to do is, so the source for your quant question can be online or can be a book, right? So Manhattan books you can use, Manhattan 5LB is a really good book, or you can use the online Magoosh portal. You will have around 700 to 800 questions on the portal, which you can do. Or even if you don't have access to that, you can download the ebooks, right? Manhattan Prep ebooks are available, and ETS official guide ebook will be available, and plenty of books, right? They will have a lot of questions. I can help you find some. I will put some links in the description, and you can always reach out to me. I will put my Instagram up there somewhere. You can just message me and I can send you some sources from which you can get the questions, right? The questions which you want to practice on. So you want these questions to be as accurate as possible around the GRE level. So I will help you with that. Now what you want to do is, for your 20 days, you just want to focus on accuracy, right? Learn how to solve these questions. So if you're weak on the concept side, I have a list of videos. So Magoosh videos are the best, right? Magoosh video concept wise, best. They're going to teach you everything from the basic up to the advanced level, and it is available on their paid portal, and I also have them. So you can find them on the internet, but if you need help finding them, just reach out to me. I will help you with those videos. And let me see, in fact, so I have AWA videos, quant videos and verbal videos. So these are all from Magoosh, and these quant videos, percents and ratios, you know, counting probability, it's segregated according to the topic or the subject, and these videos are very helpful, guys. And I have prepared these Excel sheets from where you can see these videos. So I think there's about 7 or 8 hours of verbal content and about 27 to 28 hours of math content. So for the math side, you don't need to watch all the videos, because some videos they will be teaching you what an integer is or what a fraction is. So you already know those basics, so you can easily skip those videos. But otherwise, the conceptual videos are fabulous. You want to figure out You're weak on which concept? So for me, I was weak in geometry, let's say. And I focused on the geometry videos, I finished them, and then I did a few questions on geometry, and then I brought my geometry up to the optimum level. If you need help, just reach out to me, and I will give you these videos. You can basically prepare every single topic, and you can nail the GRE. So that's on your quant side. What you're gonna do is, first 20 days, just focus on solving problems, right? Don't focus on the timer. Focus on getting the right solution. You know, first thing is you need to know how to solve these problems. I think after the 20 days, if you have solved the problems of all these subjects, you will be at a point where you know how to solve these problems, right? So any problem that comes on the GRE, you know the way to solve it. Whether or not you have the time to solve it is another problem. But right now, you know that you can solve the problem provided you have enough time. All right, once you are at that stage, then you will focus on improving your timing. First accuracy, then time. Remember this is the key. So once your accuracy is on point, you're gonna increase the timing, then use the timer. Timer is your friend, guys. Put a timer on and solve these questions. Okay, don't solve every question with a timer. What you're going to do is put a timer for 35 minutes, take a set of 20 questions. These sets are available, and you know, just solve those sets, okay? Now coming to the mock test side. So every week you're going to take one mock test, right? So on the first, so day zero, you took your first mock test. You will prepare for the 7 days, and on day eight, you will take your second mock test. So all in all, over the period of your crash course, you will have around 6 or 7 mock tests. On the last week before your exam, if possible, you can take 2-3 mock tests, right? Plenty of mock tests are available online. Many are there for free. And when you also book your GRE date, you will get 2 timed mock tests and 1 untimed mock test, which is officially from ETS, right? So those are the ones which you're gonna keep for the last, right? So just before your GRE, 1 week before, you're going to do those ETS mock tests, and they are going to be as accurate as the GRE exam is. So what you're going to do is, on those mock tests, you're definitely going to score 320 plus. And if you can score 320 plus on those mock tests, you can definitely score up to 330 on the GRE exam. So that's the plan. So let me revise the plan for you. Day zero, you will write your mock test. You will book your GRE exam if you score above 300, and you will work on gathering the sources. So you will install all the apps and get all the content on your machine available locally. You don't want to search on the internet every day for the content, right? So you have the content, you have questions, you have books, you have ebooks, right? You have them ready. So from your next day, you're going to start in the morning 50 words, and throughout the day, just revise those words, make sure you retain them really well. Apart from that, you're going to learn to do these maths questions, and you want to make sure you're accurately answering them. That accuracy is more important than timing at this point. For the 20 days, just focus on accuracy, learn all the concepts, watch those Magoosh videos, and make sure that you're able to solve these problems. Okay, so after 20 days, the remaining 25 days, you're going to focus on your timing and accuracy. So you're going to use a timer and do sets of questions. So for the first 20 days, you're doing individual questions, as many as possible, right? For the next 25 days, you're going to do sets of questions. So you will put a 35 minute timer on, and you will do 20 questions. Just how it is on the GRE. The better you simulate that environment, the better it is for you in the actual day, right? So you are aware of what you're going to get, and you are in the best position to nail the GRE. Every week, you're going to take a mock test, and you're going to analyze those results. Remember, analytics is the most important. You're going to analyze where you're scoring the marks, where you're losing the marks, right? So let's say you did a mock test and you saw that you have scored very well in the numbers and very well in the probability. You have lost marks in geometry, right? Okay, so you're going to go back to your Magoosh videos, watch the geometry videos, understand the concepts, practice a lot of questions on geometry. Then on your next mock test, you're going to measure your progress, right? Next mock test, you're going to see that your score improved on geometry, which is a sure shot sign, right? That is the proof that you have learned something and it is going to help you. And on the exam day, you know, just be calm. Don't practice anything before the exam. Just go there, have a relaxed state of mind. Nail the exam, right? I'm sure you're going to get 325 plus. Trust me, I've done it and I've seen others do it the same way. And I'm sure you guys can do it, right? If you like this video and if you want to see more content from me, just hit the thumbs up button and, you know, hit subscribe and turn on the notifications, right? You guys know the drill. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to post a lot more content on this channel. So if you find it helpful, please share it with your friends. Alright, so that's it for this video, and I'm sure you guys are going to do well on your GRE. All the best. Thanks for watching.